Alrighty, so once we've organized our qualitative data, we could go ahead and look at a way to visualize that data. A lot of the stuff that we do with the early part of statistics, collecting the data, organizing the data, visualizing the data, is just a way so that we can picture what it is that's in front of us. So the first thing that we're going to use is a bar graph. A bar graph has each variable listed on the horizontal axis, and then the frequency or the relative frequency of each of those items is shown by a rectangle, each one of equal width with space between them to the height of that frequency or relative frequency. So we're going to be using the example where we were looking at the favorite animal for 20 different preschoolers, and we're going to go ahead and draw the bar graph for this. So I've already got the relative frequency distribution done here that we can look at. That way we don't have to go and recalculate all of this stuff. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to start by drawing a vertical line and a horizontal line. And then underneath the horizontal line, I'm going to go ahead and label that with the variable. And that variable again was favorite animal or animal. And then I'm going to create a space for each of the animals that we saw. So we had dog, we had cat, we had horse, we had elephant, and I could space this out a little bit better in terms of where the words are going and also, along this line that I drew, I didn't really use the entire line. It's a little squished. That's all okay. And then on this vertical line, I'm going to go ahead and just do frequency. You could also do relative frequency here. It wouldn't change too much. It would just change how you label this. So I'm going to look at frequency, and then our highest frequency was 7. So I'm going to create some little tick marks going up to 7 at least. 2. We want these tick marks to be equally spaced. If they're not equally spaced, that's going to make things look a little bit distorted. Okay, sorry if you guys are hearing a pounding. I'm trying to get my cat to behave. All right, so I went up to 9. I didn't have to go up to 9, but I did. So now I'm going to look at dog. So dog had a frequency of 7. So above the word dog that I created, I'm going to make a rectangle that goes up to a height of 7. And then you can leave it not shaded in, or you can go ahead and color in that rectangle. It's up to you. Okay, we want to try and make sure that the lines of our rectangle are straight. I'm not so good at that. And then we're going to do the same thing. So cat had a frequency of 6. So I'm going to come up to 6. And we want this rectangle to be the same size as the one that we did for the dog. Okay, I'm going to do a little bit of erasing just because I went a little too far. Okay, and again, I'm going to go ahead and just kind of shade that in. And then horse had a frequency of 4. I'm going to come up to 4 and then across. Again, the size of the rectangle, the thickness of the rectangle should be about the same. Elephant was 2. And a giraffe was 1. And that is our bar chart. So a couple of things, or bar graph, a couple of things that are unique about bar graphs is this space here. Okay, if you're ever looking at a graph and it has space in between the bars, that means it's a bar graph. Another thing about bar graphs is they're only used with qualitative data. Okay, so all of these responses were qualitative. I don't like this word, qualitative. There we go. Okay, that's all qualitative. Once we get into quantitative data, the graph changes just a little bit. Okay, so that is our bar graph. And then another way that we can visualize data, we're not going to ever draw these, but we might see some of them, and we're going to want to know how to read them. So this is a pie chart. What a pie chart does is it takes a circle and it splits it into sections based on the percentage for that value. So when we're looking at this, we have our dog section here in yellow, 35%. So that takes up the largest piece of the pie chart. And then the sections get smaller for each animal because each animal was seen less frequently than the dog. And that's a pie chart. So visualizing qualitative data, we have pie charts, which we're not going to draw, but we could look at them, okay, figure out how to read them. And then bar charts or bar graphs, okay, I might ask you to draw a bar graph. I'm mostly going to ask you to read bar graphs, however. So being able to look at this and say, okay, here's dog, which has a height of 7, okay, goes up to the 7, so dog occurred 7 times. And that's how we visualize qualitative data.